I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Popeye the Sailor Man.
If you grew up in South Florida during the 50s, 60s, or even the 70s, you most likely have heard of Chuck Zink. He was the star of one of the longest-running and most popular kid shows in Florida and most of the USA.
At least every television station, if they had cameras, they had a kid show. That was part of the deal. The same as you had news, you had a kid show. Then you had the rest of the stuff. So we really didn't know which direction to go. And I thought, of all the different things, there's captains and there's admirals and there's this. And I've never heard anybody called a skipper. Later on, I found out there were about 100 different kid shows across the country with skipper.
But there was only one skipper in South Florida, and for over 24 years, he topped the ratings with a morning show that did more than just entertain kids while they were getting ready for school.
The ratings were fantastic. And from time to time, we literally would have a larger audience in the morning than NBC's Today Show. We booked 50 kids a day, 5 days a week. It was a live show. In the beginning and throughout the show, we always tried to make it light and be entertaining. We didn't preach. And the one thing that I sort of always tried to do is ask the kids to come up to my level, not me getting down on them. And they liked that.
More than just kids liked it, the corporate world took notice too. But that didn't happen until Chuck Zink made a demand, one that would change the face of television.
One day I was walking through the hallway where the receptionist who took reservations for the show, and I happened to hear this person sitting behind the desk. She said, "By the way, are you black on the telephone?" And I did it. I couldn't believe. So the minute she got off the telephone, I said, "Why did you ask her that question?" She says, "Oh, I have to, Chuck." I said, "Why?" She said, "We can't put the black and the white together." I really, really, I said, "Don't ever say that again." And I said, "Anybody that calls here, they can be on the show, whether they're black or green or yellow." I went to my boss and the owner, Mr. Wolfson, and I said, "We can't segregate this show." And he said, "It's your show."
This was a bold move in 1958. The Civil Rights Act was only 6 years away, but Chuck wouldn't change his position, even if it meant losing his sponsor.
And the saddest part of it is that Mr. Wolfson, one of the closest friends that he had, was Mr. Singer, who owned the Royal Castle. And they received the news and they said, "They're sorry, but we can't put up with that." And they canceled. Within a month, two guys had just bought out a company called Burger King from Jacksonville, moved down here, and Burger King became my sponsor, my main sponsor for the rest of the time.
Skipper Chuck's Playhouse continued to set the pace until FCC deregulation caused station management to cancel the show.
There was just so much love in that show, backstage of the show, and the people that participated. I think the greatest thing that I got out of the Skipper Chuck show, believe it or not, was the fact that people come up to me practically every day, and they are now grown. And they ultimately, before they say goodbye, will say, "Boy, I just wish you had a show like this for my kid."
Well, I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm stronger than the